Dear GCM family, this is Pastor Ben, and this video is going out on Wednesday, July the 29th. We will have dinner served tonight in the fellowship hall and to-go boxes from 5 to 7 p.m., along with ministry CDs available and beds and desserts as well. If you'd like something delivered, please do let us know. We'd be glad to bring it by. It'd be no trouble at all. We pray the Lord's blessings for you. For today's 5 minutes for your faith message, it's going to be entitled The Hour of Glory, or the full message is entitled The Finest Hour, which is available if you can pull it up on this same YouTube feed here. But during the course of this past week, I was watching some bowling that they came out with. It's the only sport that I've ever really been any good at, and about the only sport that I ever watch as well. And they had some of the current stars on there bowling against some of the stars from yesteryear. You know you're getting more 29 when the bowling stars from years gone by who are now in their 50s and up to 60 are the ones that you remember better than the ones of today that are 20-something. But at any rate, they were on there bowling together, and the young stars, well, they haven't had their hour of glory yet. For the most part, they haven't accomplished their greatest achievements. And truth be told, as much as I love the ones from years gone by, their hour of glory, as it is often be viewed, has already come and gone, at least in the sport. When you think of finest hours, people will think of different things or hours of glory. They will think of great success that they've had in a sport or a profession, perhaps in fame or fortune or what have you, or something in which they take great personal pride, whatever that area might be. But when we look at Jesus's finest hour, Jesus's hour of glory as presented in the Gospel of John, it's quite different from what we might think. Jesus's hour of glory, when he talks about his hour coming, it wasn't when he did his first miracle of turning water into wine in John chapter 2. It wasn't when he healed the man that was paralyzed at the pool of Bethesda in John chapter 5. Or when he fed the thousands by multiplying the provisions in John chapter 6. Or healing the man that was born blind in John chapter 9. Or even the raising of Lazarus from the dead after he'd been dead 4 days in John chapter 11. No, none of these was classified in John's gospel as Jesus' hour of greatest glory. John chapter 12 begins the triumphal entry where they heralded him as king with waving palm branches and what we've come to call Palm Sunday. But even that was not his hour of greatest glory as presented in the Gospel of John. No, John's Gospel very clearly points out that Jesus' hour of greatest glory is when he was lifted up on the cross to die. Not for his sins, but for yours, for mine. That's when Jesus had his hour of greatest glory, as presented in the Gospel of John. I will tell you, I don't know what you might consider your hour of greatest glory to be, but I can tell you this, that biblically, if someone is not a believer in Christ, then their hour of greatest glory, their best hour here in this life, is indeed, that would be their finest hour in this life, but it is not good enough. It says filthy rags before God. It's not enough righteousness to earn heaven. And if it is that you are a believer in Jesus Christ, then Jesus dying upon the cross made it possible for your name to be put into the Lamb's Book of Life, for your sins, though they be red as scarlet, to be washed whiter than snow. And indeed, our greatest hour is to come, for one day, those who are believers in Christ will finally and fully be set free from the weights which so easily beset us here in this life. And we will worship the Lamb of glory who died for us on the cross. We will give him thanks and we will give him praise forevermore. Thanks be to God for the hour of glory for Jesus on the cross that would pave the way for all who'd put their trust in him to be received unto the Father and saved from the sin of the world. May God bless you abundantly.